Hi everybody, welcome to a new video. Today we're gonna learn how to install FileZilla on your computer, but we're gonna use Ubuntu this time. So what you do is like maybe you want to download your website on your local server, and then you don't have a file. You know those FTP, sometimes they do what? Their software, cPanel software, sometimes doesn't give you a chance to download all stuff. They can give you a chance to download only one by one file. So FileZilla is the one which we use. FileZilla download. You don't do that if you have Ubuntu. It's pretty simple. You'd go to, we're gonna copy this, then we minimize everything here. Then we go to this, and you type in software. After getting software, you click here, and then you go to search, then say file. No, we type in, we copy and paste this FileZilla. We get it, you double click here. Once you double click that, you say install. It's gonna ask you for your password. Okay, you authenticate, then it's gonna start downloading. It's saying preparing this. Let's wait and see. Installing. It's a very small file. I don't think it's gonna take that much longer. Let's wait and see. It says FileZilla is a full-featured FTP client with an easy-to-use GUI. They are not lying to you. This is so easy. It is written in C++ and uses the WXWidgets library. You can see it's easy. FileZilla includes the following features: supports FTP over SSL / TLS, FTPS. And SSH, file transfer protocol SFTP, IPv6 support, available in more than 40 languages. You get me, support. Everything is here, so you can read a couple of things here. Then after that, we close. Then we look for FileZilla. FileZilla. You click there. You open the file. Say okay. Asking questions in the FileZilla forum. Report bug if you want to do basic usage instructions. Configuring FileZilla and your network. Further documentation. Say okay. So now what happens is you click here. You can click here. Once you click here, you put a new site. Once you put a new site, you say new site. Then you're gonna rename that site. Maybe I'm gonna call it whatever name I want to say, DD. Then I say I can come here on FTP. Then I put in the site name, the port number. Here you can leave it the way it is. You can leave normal. You can use a username and password. Once you put in that, you say connect. You can also go to these settings if you want. Once you say connect, that site is gonna come under this. Let me say okay. Let me click and go back here. Okay, the site was not created, but because I didn't put it in here. But if I did put in the username, password and stuff, it was gonna be super cool. It was gonna be easy to put in, then you download. So once you download, what you're gonna do, once you log into your website, it's gonna come here. Everything, each file, you're gonna click here. So after clicking there, then the file is gonna be what? The file is gonna be here. You will like as you say this, you just cut, drag and drop here. You drag and drop this side, you drag and drop this side, all the files you want to send. Once you send them all, it's gonna be fine. Once everything is fine, then it's gonna be easy for you to do what? To do everything you want. So I think that should be not something difficult for you to do. So all the folders gonna be here. You can see all the folders here. So if you wanna put the files in my documents, you go there, you click there, you find the document you're looking for. Or if you wanna go until to your var, I usually click to var, then I go to www directory here. That's where I save everything. Sometimes I go to inside HTML, then there's this website here. That's what I use. I click here, then I drop each and everything I want in here. So after dropping everything here, then I'm done. So once you're done, you can click to, you can go here and go to your location you want to save things in. Remember, I clicked in var, then you go to www, then you go to HTML if you want to be maybe running a PHP site here. So what you do, you can click here and find all your files. Or before you do that, you can come here and say, you write the website, I'll say maybe facebook.com. That's the website, all my website files, I wanna drop them there. So once you click this, once you're done with this, what you do, you cancel here, you look for FileZilla, you click here. After there, then I wanna look for that, what, that directory. I'm gonna say HTML again, directory, then I say HTML, then I say click here. Okay, HTML, inside HTML, you can see this is Facebook. Once you double click on that folder, it's gonna come here. So the files you're gonna get this side, you're gonna just drag and drop, drag and drop, drag and drop. So each and everything is gonna be shown up here. Direction, remote file, size, priority, status. The status is gonna be showing here. Maybe you have 200 gig, maybe you've downloaded 20, maybe 30. Once it's finished, it's gonna also show here and say successful transfers, failed transfers, and queued files. So queued files are the files which are waiting to be transferred. The failed ones, the ones gonna fail, and the successful ones are the ones which you're gonna see on your what, on your local machine. Same applies to if you want to upload the files. You do the same thing. You click on that site. The site is gonna come here. You're gonna get site files here. You just say drag and drop this site. You drag and drop that site. Whatever files you put in here, they're gonna come. You get me? Yeah. You can see transfer process default file extension default type, whatever pre-server, timestamp and all that stuff. You get me? Server. You can look into this, add to bookmark, view, toolbar, all those things are here. Local directory tree, remote directory tree, transfer queue, edit, clear private data, all, everything is here. So you can play by one, but you've seen now how to install it, and I believe that's gonna help you guys, and I hope that the video here, it has helped you, though we didn't log into any website, but we showed you how to download it and how it works. So if you find any problems, please leave something in the comment box below. We're gonna be back to you in we can do a tutorial which you're looking for, that we will not hesitate to do that. We are nothing without you guys, and we really appreciate your support each and every day. This was a simple tutorial, though we did try to make it a little bit longer so that we explain some other things. Some people, they put here the host name, which is www, then they put the username here, and they put the password and put the port. You get me? So some of them do like that. So then you can say quick connect, you can do that, or you can select clear, whatever. But some of us, we use this when you say add a site. When you add a site, you never log in again. Once it's logged in, once it's saved, you just click and then you log into the site. You get me? Thanks for watching, guys. Don't forget to subscribe. See you in the next video. Bye-bye.